Sometimes assigning a super type to a subtype can be allowed even if the room for the substitution is not does not allow to assign a super type to a subtype. So sometimes this rule can be made less stricter to allow certain cases in which a super type holds is of the subtype that the variable that has to be assigned is. For example, for a vehicle, for a variable v of type vehicle, and it gets assigned a variable c of type car that holds an object of type car, which is a subtype of vehicle. If C gets assigned to V, it will be assigned correctly to V because a car is a subtype of vehicle. And then after that, if another assignment is done to assign the variable in vehicle in the variable in V to the object in V. So to assign the value in V to C after C is assigned to V, it will not work because even if the value in V is of type car because of the first assignment, the second assignment assigns a super type assigns a value that is held in a super type variable. So the compiler, which reads the code line by line and looks at every line in isolation without knowing about what is stored in a variable, will give an error because it will not allow a super type variable to assign its value to a subtype variable, and even if the super type variable can hold a subtype object. So what can be done is to allow this assignment with what is called a cast operation, which is done by adding the subtype into parentheses before the expression or the variable that that is needed to be assigned, and this will make it able to compile the code even with this assignment. And then the runtime checks whether the variable that holds the object to be assigned is of that type, in our case of type car. Otherwise, if this is not true, there will be a runtime error, which is called a cast call exception, something like that. And we'll stop the program immediately. It's a cast class exception, something like that. And the program will stop running immediately. A variable that holds subtype that is different than the subtype to which it has to be assigned, for example, a variable of type bicycle gets assigned to a variable of type car. So the bicycle variable can never hold a type of car. So a bicycle can never be a car, so it will never be allowed by the compiler. Even if it's cast to bicycle, no, like, well, it will never be the bicycle will never be a thing. And then assigning bicycle to bicycle type variable to vehicle type variable can be done with a cast to bicycle. The cast operation shouldn't be used too much. It should be rarely used in Java because it can lead to runtime errors, and in practice the cast operation is done very rarely when the classes are well structured, and also in almost all cases when a cast, every cast can be refactored, can be replaced by refactoring the code so that the cast is not needed anymore, And this is usually what is done, and the cast operation is substituted usually by a polymorphic method call that will be seen in the next chapter.